2013. Please join me up here. Okay, great. I wanted to share a few words with you. Over the years, I've shared a lot of words with all of you, and so I am excited to see you on the next, the new book in your life. I heard that last night at graduation. Somebody said, not the next chapter, but the next book. So that, I think that's an exciting way to look at it. So I wanted to share with you, you're receiving a gift today from our church, and this, what I'm reading to you, is in that gift. And it's talking about the movie Chariots of Fire and Eric Liddell. It says, I'm just going to read this part. In the movie Chariots of Fire, it celebrates the life of Scotland's Eric Liddell, a much sought-after celebrity in his day. As the 400-meter gold medalist in the 1924 Olympics, he had become something of an icon to his fellow citizens, and everyone wanted to see him run. Every Scot wanted to revel in Eric's accomplishments and hold parties in his honor. The newspapers couldn't write enough about him, and he was Scotland's biggest star. But at the height of his running career, Eric shocked his fans by choosing to walk away from a life of fame and prominence to pursue a higher calling. At a dinner party, Eric announced, "It has been a wonderful experience to compete in the Olympic Games and to bring home a gold medal. But since I've been a young lad, I've had my eyes on a different prize. You see, every one of us is in a greater race, and I have run in Paris, and this race ends when God gives out the medals. It has always been my intention to be a missionary, and I have just received word that I have been accepted as a chemistry teacher in China." The crowd was shunned, and many were disappointed. Eric had struggled with his decision, but he knew in his heart that he was being called to take the gospel to China. He was not seeking his own good, but the good of others far away, and that goal was, for him, truly worth the sacrifice. I'm not asking you all to go to China. We already have one friend there. I'm asking you to do whatever God is wanting you to do. In Philippians chapter 3, starting with verse 12, it says, not that I have already reached the goal. Let's all think about ourselves there, because none of us have reached the goal. Not that I have already reached the goal or am already fully mature, but I make every effort to take hold of it, because I also have been taken hold of by Christ Jesus. Brothers, I do not consider myself to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do. Forgetting what is behind and marching forward to what is ahead, I pursue as my goal the prize promised by God's heavenly call in Christ Jesus. Therefore, all who are mature should think this way. And if you think differently about anything, that God will reveal this to you also. In any case, we should live up to whatever truth we have attained. Join in imitating me, brothers, and observe those who live according to the example you have in us. For I have often told you, and now say again with tears, that many live as enemies of Christ. Their end is destruction, their God is their stomach, their glory is in their shame. They are focused on earthly things. But our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for a Savior, Jesus Christ our Lord. In the last verse, verse 21, it says, He will transform the body of our humble condition into the likeness of His glorious body by the power that enables Him to subject everything to Himself. Hey, moms and dads of these people, would you mark this down for them, Philippians 3, 12 through 20, so that that can be some truths that they cling to? We want to live our lives holy and pleasing to God. And I love all of you. You know, I can think of individual experiences that we've all shared. I love you. I know all of these people here love you, and we are so proud of you. I don't want to cry, so I'm going to quit talking and give you a present. You get to hold that. Let's hear it for our graduates. You see all these people who love you? We have a slideshow for you to watch now. You know, you've seen a few of these before. So you can turn around and watch here, or you can watch there, whichever way. So if y'all roll the slideshow now. You can turn around and watch this.
This is where it begins. This is where all the worry ends. This is where I say I don't need to have control. This is where I admit.
To pray. Let's pray together. Can we, like, you know, I might not get to pray with y'all all together again. Come on. Let's pray. God, I thank you for these kids. Lord, I pray for your blessings on them. I pray for your protection to go before them. I pray that you would guide them, Lord, in everything they do. Lord, that you would help them to cling to one another, their brothers and sisters in Christ. Lord, that you would help them to be unified with one another. And that you would give them wisdom and direction, God, that you would let your thoughts be their thoughts and your ways their ways for all of us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.